Good grief. This is now out of control. Even if in Cairo, this hour, they're trying to get back under control and back to business. Tens of billions in foreign aid, and this is what we get for it? Protesters furious at the guy who got it and us for giving it. Because here's what $100 billion in Egyptian aid gets you over the course of 30 years, an approval rating of 17% among Egyptians. That's how many have a good opinion of us. Some 82% do not. Do not. I have no idea what the other 1% feel. And of that great military in whom we place so much faith, we'll talk to our own Greg Palcott about whether they left so much as a finger.
Egyptian soldiers standing there, Egyptians with guns, Egyptian soldiers watching as the two of us are being pummeled close to our death, doing absolutely nothing. My own
instincts. Well, as you know by now, Greg is lucky to be alive. It may be time for us to just wake up. Jacob Hornberger is the president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, says, you bet it's time to wake up. But Jacob, these are startling numbers, and we could quibble over how big they are, how small they are. They're a lot of money. And over the course of the $100 billion or so that Egypt's gotten from us, a lot of it has made its way only to Hosni Mubarak.
Well, how can this surprise anyone? I mean, you know, we've often argued that libertarians have that foreign aid is just a nice, sophisticated form of bribery. A lot of it ends up in the pockets and the Swiss bank accounts of the dictators. But more fundamentally, Neil, we need to be asking ourselves as Americans exactly what the Egyptian people are asking themselves. That what business does our government have supporting a dictatorship for 30 years that the Egyptian people now are finally protesting against? Americans need to be challenging their government the same way the Egyptians are challenging their dictatorship that our government has supported.
The argument for just pulling money out of the region altogether and foreign aid out altogether, expressed by likes of Ron Paul and others, is that you can't buy people's love. At best, you could stay off their anger, but only for a while. What do you make of that?
Well, it's absolutely true, but it's even worse than that because you end up supporting regimes all too often that use that money, that use the military means, the intelligence forces, to oppress the people. Yeah. So you're generating anger and hatred within a certain class of society, and that anger and hatred is going to be directed not just against the regime that's doing it to them, rightfully or wrongfully, it's going to be directed to the regime that's providing them the means to do it to them.
Well, one thing I'm worried about, Jacob, is we kind of have the top recipients of U.S. foreign aid. Some are understandable. Afghanistan recently, given our military commitment, Israel, key ally in the region. Even there, Rand Paul says maybe we should just hang that up. But that in the end, the fear is that if we don't give money to this region, they'll just run to somebody else. What do you make of that? Because I've always thought when it comes to oil, we're their biggest customer, that is for OPEC, even though Egypt's not a member per se, but an influential player in the region, that it's not as if they could cut their nose to spite this.
Well, we see that with Venezuela. I mean, Venezuela has a regime that's antagonistic to the United States, yet they have no reluctance selling oil. Their position is they want to make money. That's the way markets work. People are trying to maximize their best interests, and so it places a penalty on them if they start to discriminate against people they don't like. I think what we need to do as Americans is challenge this entire paradigm of foreign aid to every country, interventionism, empire, all the military bases.
Yeah, but to countries that don't need it, I mean, we were even providing aid, military and otherwise, in terms of credits to the Saudis. Last time I checked, fairly wealthy in their own right. So there must be a point at which you say, all right, in the scheme of a couple of $1 trillion worth of federal spending when you're giving $38 billion away, the ambassador was effectively telling me last night, Neil, take a chill pill. This isn't that big a deal. But I'm saying I measure everything by how much bang you get for the buck, and we don't appear to be getting much bang here.
No, you're getting negative bang. And I think there's a more fundamental issue, too, is why should the American people be forced to fund these regimes? It's really just an international welfare plan for foreign regimes. Why shouldn't people be free to keep their own money and decide who to donate it to? If Americans want to donate part of
it. It actually sees the opposite result. That's what I was trying to say, Jacob. Now we're hearing from the protesters, our popularity has actually waned since these protests began. And now that it's seeking in Egypt, that Hosni Mubarak could be worth north of $70 billion, a figure the ambassador quibbled with. I'll give him that. I don't know how much it is in the end. It's safe to say well into the billions. They're figuring, well, Americans gave him that. Americans propped him up to give him that. We're mad at both.
Absolutely. And they provided the tear gas and the bullets and the armaments that are potentially being used against these people, or in reality being used against them. Why shouldn't they be angry against the U.S. government for doing this? Wouldn't we be if we were in a similar situation?